Hey Capricorn, it's Suzanne with Sunny Forest Tarot here to do a weekly reading for you. Okay, so I want to let you know we're going to take a look at challenges this week a little bit. So some of them are really, I feel like they've been really nice readings this week, actually. It forces, when I ask certain questions of each card, you know, I'm allowing myself to go deeper this week. You might notice a difference. I don't always do that. So we're going a little deeper. These light blue cards are going to represent you. All right. And the gray cards are going to represent your person. Of course, in a general reading, whoops, that doesn't belong there. In a general reading, you know, the characters could be switched. They could be flip-flopped, okay? So however it resonates for you. But my intention is the light blue cards represent you. And what I want to say about the challenges, you know, that we're taking a look at, you know, if you're happy most of the time in your connection or your relationship, this probably isn't the reading for you. I don't want anyone looking for trouble, so to speak, okay? All right. And then we're going to use some of my cards as well, and we'll end with some oracle cards. These readings are, like I said, are a little bit longer. Some of you like the shorter readings. Most of you, I find that my audience tends to like the longer readings. I personally like doing the longer readings. I feel like I'm gypping you if I don't. So anyway, let's take a look. So the first two cards here represent the biggest challenge from your perspective, from their perspective. Okay, so let's see what we have for you. What is the biggest challenge? Five of Pentacles. Okay, so on some level here, you know, you might feel like you are missing somebody. You might feel like somebody isn't giving you the attention that you hope for. You might feel, in some cases, you might feel like you were left behind in some way or left out in the cold somehow. Either way, any of those scenarios, any of those situations, at the end of the day, this card is about a vibration of lack. Okay? It can be lacking. You might feel like you lack the finances to get together with somebody. You might feel like you lack some, you know, personal traits that you should have in order to be with this person. You're carrying the energy of lack in some way, okay? And that is a challenge, okay? Whether you realize it or not, you might even be with this person. You might be talking with this person. You might be connecting with this person. It's important to know that you're carrying that energy for some reason. All right. What does this person see as the biggest challenge? Eight of Cups. Interesting. That's very interesting. The Eight of Cups, as you know, can be the energy of walking away. This can also be the energy of coming back, however, okay? This person might be struggling, okay, to come back to you in some way fully because you carry that energy of lack, okay? So this person might want to come back. This person might be trying to come back, but at the end of the day, if you're carrying this vibration, it makes it very difficult for this person to come back towards you because on some level, you might hold some belief that you don't deserve this person, okay? This also could be that they know at some point that they left you behind and that's what's making it hard for it to come back and that's why you're feeling this Five of Pentacles being left out in the cold. Or it could be that you did this. You walked away. You might have walked away from your feelings of this connection at some point. Either way, It's something like that. So what is it that both of you are thinking about? What dominates your thoughts right now? For you, what do we have? The Fool. All right. So I love this card. I love the Fool because there's really no downside to the Fool. So if you are thinking about taking a risk when it comes to this person, maybe saying something off the cuff, surprising them, you know, giving them a call, taking a risk, moving towards the unknown in some way with this person, it can only benefit you. It can only benefit you. No matter what the outcome is, this energy can only benefit you. And it definitely pulls you out of this energy of lack. We're gonna clarify these, okay? But I love seeing that for you. For this person, what do we have? Six of Wands. Okay, so no matter what this person is presenting to you, I feel like what they think about is, why couldn't I make it work with Capricorn? Or why am I struggling making it work with Capricorn? I want this to work with Capricorn. So what is it? Why can't we figure this out? Six of Wands, victory and love. That's what this person is trying to figure out. It's very possible and very likely that you were the one in some way that pulled away from your feelings from this person, whether you see it that way or not. All right, so right here, what needs to be discussed between the two of you? What needs to be discussed? For you, Nine of Swords. Nine of Swords. There's something that you carry, okay? And I feel like this ties to the challenge, the Five of Pentacles, the challenge that you have, which is this energy of lack. Nine of Swords, what do you worry about? You worry about possibly not having what this person desires or wants or loves. On some level, that needs to be discussed. That might be hard to discuss. That might be difficult to discuss. And it's interesting, the Fool is sitting between these two cards. For this person, what do they want to discuss? Knight of Swords. I feel like, and I don't know if it's this person or if it's you, but I feel like somebody was very, and the best word I have for this is clumsy, very clumsy or very sloppy about something that was said between the two of you at some point. It could have been this person that said it. It could have been you that said it. But it was said in haste. You know, it was said with, it was just not well thought out. Not well thought out communication. And it might have been said on a whim. All right. So, do we both want to move forward? That's the last question. Do we both want to move forward here? Let's see. For you, Queen of Cups. Yes, you do. You do want to move forward. You hold very deep feelings for this person. You're looking at your feelings right now. You're looking at potentially love that you have for this person. But, you know, we've got two really beautiful cards here sandwiched, you know, with two cards that, you know, are a little bit of a struggle. What do we have for this person? Ace of Wands. Yes. They also want to move forward. Ace of Wands, this person, you know, I feel like they have, there's more masculine energy down here. I feel like this person wants to connect with you physically. I feel like you want to connect with this person emotionally. It's like you want to either, you want to hear the words. You want to connect emotionally, I feel like. And this person, I feel like they think that passion could solve a lot in this case. And it might. It might. Sometimes communication is overrated. So let's get some clarification here. All right, so for you, we're going to clarify the Five of Pentacles, the Fool, and the Nine of Swords. And for your person down here, we're going to clarify Eight of Cups, Six of Wands, and Knight of Swords. Okay, so for you, Five of Pentacles clarified. Look at this, Eight of Cups. So this is definitely about somebody that walked away. They might have walked, you know, Eight of Cups is walking away with a purpose. If, you know, either somebody couldn't, for some reason, make the relationship work. I mean, this could be past energy, but you and them are focused on the same thing. Somebody left this connection for a reason. It might have been to maybe move somewhere. It might have been, you know, it could have been a change of a job, and it could have been because they couldn't handle the emotions of this connection, or you couldn't handle the emotions of this connection. Either way, you definitely feel a sense of loss here, and you are missing somebody. What do we have here for them? We have the Black Newman. So this is a special card in this particular deck, okay? And this person might have been exposed to your dark side, okay? Or they showed their dark side. But somebody here, Eight of Cups, and truthfully, you both might have walked away in some fashion here, okay? And for them, I feel like it was something that they didn't want. They didn't want, whether they did it or whether you did it, I don't feel like they wanted to do that, okay? And that's a big part of the challenge here. This tells me that the two of you are not completely talking honestly. You know, truly, truly honestly. This could be a miscommunication of some kind too. All right, so when we're looking at what's dominating our thoughts, it feels like you want to take a risk with this person in some way. Eight of Pentacles, you want to put effort into this again. You want to see this person face to face, okay? And I feel like that's how you want to engage with this person. Like the next time you talk to this person, I feel like you want to be face to face. I feel like that's important. I want to get one more on that. Page of Swords. Yeah, it feels to me like for you, you'll know by looking at this person, you'll get a lot more information by being face to face with this person, whether it's on a Zoom or in person or, you know, on FaceTime. I feel like being face to face with them is going to be really important. So it's like that part of you just wants to see them, wants to look in their eyes. That's important. That's what you're thinking about. For your person, Six of Wands, Hierophant. So this person is thinking about commitment. They might be thinking about, you know, again, Six of Wands is, you know, is a victory in love in some way. Hierophant is commitment or marriage, or taking a look at, they might be taking a look at their core values, especially, you know, if they made some type of dark move here that maybe showed a negative side of themselves or the shadow side of who they are. But they're thinking about what they want to commit to, what they want to commit their heart to. One more for that too. Five of Wands. Yeah, so they're thinking about this because they don't really know where they stand with you. And frankly, I don't feel like you really know where you stand with them either. And that tells me that there's not a lot of good communication here. There might not be any communication, but there's not a lot of good communication here. Nine of Swords, this is what needs to be discussed. Page of Cups, do you feel on some level that you owe this person an apology for some reason? Again, it easily could be, you know, I almost feel like you both could feel like you owe the other an apology because the Eight of Cups is here for both of you. I almost feel like there's confusion about who left who. I'm not sure how that really happens, but I feel like for a lot of you, that could be happening. And then here, for this person, again, sloppy communication. And if there was sloppy communication or a miscommunication somewhere, that could be how both of you might feel like you might have walked away, or you both feel like the other one walked away. So what do we have here? Strength, card of Leo. So this feels like a very deep, vulnerable conversation because it's calling on this person to be vulnerable. It's calling on you to, I feel like, tell your deepest worries or concerns about this connection. And it might show Nine of Swords and Page of Cups that you have fear of reaching out to this person or fear of them rejecting an apology of yours. So what does this person need to be vulnerable about? Wheel of Fortune. I feel like this is being vulnerable about where they want to go with you, what they see as the destined path for both of you. Okay? This feels like a very serious, deep conversation that needs to happen here that will make both of you feel so much better. Let's get one more for you on this Page of Cups. What is it that you might feel like you need to apologize for? Ace of Swords. You might have told the truth in a very harsh way, or this person perceived some type of truth in a harsh way. But I feel like this is, you know, what needs to be discussed is the truth. Whatever the truth is for you, whatever this person sees as their destiny with you, is going to make them feel very vulnerable. All right. So let's get one on the Queen of Cups for you about where this is going. And the Ace of Wands for your person. Queen of Cups, Knight of Swords. And then for them, Ace of Wands and Five of Cups. All right, so I almost feel like we're destined to possibly make the mistake again, okay? Because we've got Knight of Swords here, Knight of Swords here. We've got Five of Cups. It's almost like this conversation could go really well for some of you, and it prompts a really intimate moment, a really intimate time between the two of you. And if the communication doesn't go well here, where we're not completely honest, I feel like you might end up saying something clumsy, or you might say something just in haste, you know, and that, like, that covers up this Queen of Cups. Or you might hastily express your love in a way that you didn't expect to express it. And it ends up being hurtful to this person, Five of Cups. Like it kind of squashes the fire. Kind of squashes the fire. Let's get one more here. Ten of Swords. So I feel like it's really important, you know, whatever conversation you tend to have next with this person, it's really, really important to be really true to your heart. No matter how embarrassing it is or what you see as embarrassing, no matter how vulnerable it makes you feel, it's really important because I feel like this person could easily feel betrayed. It could easily bring out this Black Newman in them again. It could bring out their dark side. Like I feel both people could be easily triggered because both of you on some level feel like the other person walked away at some point. So our feelings and our emotions are very sensitive. We're very, you know, I'm surprised the Seven of Wands didn't come out here. All right, so let's see. Let's get some additional cards here. It feels like this is like one of those readings where it feels like there's a lot of feelings here. There could be a lot of love here, but it gets all mixed up because time has gone by. There might be distance between the two of you. So what ends up happening is we end up coming to our own conclusions in our thoughts. You know, Nine of Swords. All right, so let's get one for you. Let's get one for this person. One for you. One for your person. One for you and one for your person. All right, so let's see what message comes out for you. What do we have? Resistance. A lot of times, you know, this can come from that energy of lack, okay? Sexual. Euphoric. Wow, that card didn't come out very good, did it? Note to self. All right. Anyways, so for you, you might be feeling sexual resistance from this person, or you might be putting out sexual resistance to this person. You know, when we match euphoric with sexual, I feel like the desire here from you to this person, you know, feels almost euphoric. When you think about this person in a sexual manner or you're very sexually attracted to this person, which in essence is desire. And desire can actually cause resistance, okay? So something is going on there. These are going to mean different things to different people. All right, so for your person down here, what do we have? Needs. Loving. Together. Holy cow, do you see that? Needs, loving, together. That's beautiful. Okay, so you're very focused on the desire, which is that energy of lack, believe it or not. What we desire is what we lack, essentially, right? Because if we're desiring them, that says we don't have them. So it's important to, when you think about this person, to almost experience them as though they are with you, all right? I feel like you're extremely, right now, you might be extremely sexually attracted to this person. This person is literally telling you that they need loving together with you. So it's like these cards are meant to give us kind of a message underneath the message, all right? And I find when I use these three decks together like this, sometimes we actually get a direct message like that, which is cool. All right, so I'm using the biggest cards that I have, which are too big for my hands. And we're going to get one final oracle message for you. And one final message for this person. What do we have for you? We have ancestors, strength, love, and support. So I always look at this card as there are souls that are out there that are protecting you, that are supporting you, giving you strength, love, and support without you even knowing it. Okay? So no matter what situation you're going through, you're never alone. I truly believe that. All right? So if you're struggling with this connection right now, realize that you are supported, not only from your loved ones, but from angels, okay, from spirit, and from the universe or God or, you know, a higher power. All you have to do is ask for that support if you need it. Okay, and then for this person, what do we have here? We have allowing success and good fortune into your life, part of a greater collective. All right, we'll just leave it there. Capricorn, that is what I have for you. This just feels like almost. It's like we're almost there. It's like, can we both get it right at the same time? That's what it feels like. All right, guys, if you're looking for a deeper, more personal reading, certainly reach out to me. If not, no problem. I will talk to you next week. All right, thanks so much. Bye.